is out. They've set the pan, the water line, the valve, the wall fill. They'll be installing the custom wall surround next, working around the window. Should be just a few more hours. We'll let them finish up. Let's see how they did. Wow. Love this. Yes, that low step pan, that's going to be a real game changer. Not having to step over that high tub skirt, that's going to make getting in and out so much easier. And look how much space has opened up in the corners and the walls. This just feels like a bigger bathroom. Folks, you saw it again here today. West Shore Home can transform your bathroom, and they can do it in just one day. So if your bath is in need of an upgrade, know that West Shore Home makes it easy. Call the number on your screen right now. Set up that free in-home design consultation. And when you do, take advantage of this great offer. For a very limited time, West Shore Home is offering this exclusive offer. 5 years of 0% interest financing. And if you call in right now, take 50% off installation. Call West Shore Home now.
Your precious heirlooms deserve to be pampered, groomed, and cared for. We're talking about your oriental and area rugs, of course. Your showpieces get dirty just like regular carpet, but need to be cleaned differently. Caravan Rugs uses centrifugal force technology to thoroughly and safely clean and dry your oriental and area rugs. Caravan Rugs makes it easy with pickup and delivery in the Triangle and surrounding areas. Call Caravan Rugs today or visit us online to read our reviews and schedule your next cleaning.
Original series now screening.
See what's happening this instant. ABC 11 Eyewitness News at 11:30 starts right now.
Tonight, new details on the proposed East End project, East End Market project, I should say, that could bring more businesses to Raleigh. While some residents who live near the site were opposed the rezoning for the development, they're now having a change of heart after they say the developer changed plans to ease their concerns. Diane Wilson is here with the latest on the plans.
The residents who live right in front of this proposed project said they went into this fight with no faith in the process. But after having their concerns heard, they're now giving the green light for the project to move forward. The East End Market project at the northeastern corner of Whitaker Mill and Wake Forest Roads appears to be on track to becoming closer to reality, even after residents who live next door to it opposed it.
It's been a really stressful 6 months, but at least at the 11th hour, they were willing to sit down with us and
Beth Carmichael, who lives right next door to the proposed development, started a petition about their concerns and got the attention of the developers.
They brought us all to the table and we said, okay, these are the specific things that we're going to need in order for us to be comfortable having this development here.
Working with Raleigh City Council member David Knight, Carmichael says the developer agreed to make several changes, including doubling setbacks from the neighboring community, adding additional landscaping buffers, making parking conditions safe, and easing traffic concerns.
It is going to enhance the community at large, and it gives us enough privacy that we can live with it.
Residents credit the help of Council Member Knight with getting the developer to make these changes to the project, which includes a mix of commercial, retail, and residential units.
I think they came to a solution, an outcome that they felt was in their best interest and for what could happen otherwise, and I think they felt that that was the best way to move forward for the community.
And Knight says Raleigh City Council plans to vote on the rezoning of this proposed project on Tuesday. In Raleigh, I'm Diane Wilson, ABC 11 Eyewitness News.
Raleigh's city manager hopes to name the next police chief by July 1st. This week, the three finalists got a chance to make their case to you during a virtual forum. The candidates in the running are Rob Lowe, a deputy superintendent of the Cambridge Police Department in Massachusetts, Daryl McSwain, the chief of police for the Maryland National Capitol Park Police, and Estella Patterson, a deputy chief of the Charlotte-Mecklenburg Police Department.
So in order to build trust and legitimacy, the community has to trust you, certainly, but you build that legitimacy by having integrity, by having transparency, and also by having accountability.
I believe in educating the community on what the challenges are, but also also given them tools in which they can actually help, whether it be through anonymous phone lines, tip lines, and also cash reward.
I think for me, being present is important, and that means when there's an issue in the community and you're trying to solve problems, you have to be there. And one of the things that I like to do is I like to get as close to the problem as I can.
All right, this looks competitive. One of the finalists will replace the current chief, Cassandra Deck Brown, who is retiring at the end of the month. A shortage of bus drivers here in the Triangle is so...